الحمد لله، نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وخليله، رسوله وعبده الذي أدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل دينه حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جزيت به نبيا عن قومه ورسولا عن أمته. اللهم أحينا على سنته وأمتنا على ملته، واحشرنا تحت لوائه وأوردنا حوضه، واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. We are continuing to track the signs of the Day of Judgment, since they are living with us and we are living with them. Those minor signs that are almost complete mean one thing and one thing only, that we are only waiting for the bigger signs, the major signs. And this is an alarm that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His bounty of grace, He has furnished us with something we can read, we can look at, we can evaluate, and He gives us a chance to correct. We all know the hadith that some people will be doing a lot of good work, the work of the people of paradise, until they become about 2 feet or 3 feet away from paradise, one arm's length, and then whatever is preordained for them to do, they will do, and then they will end up in hellfire. The opposite is also true. So it became very important that we know what are the signs of the Day of Judgment. And it is not enough to know them in general, because we need to be careful to define them as they come by. In the hadith narrated by the companion Abbas Abs al-Ghifari, the Prophet ﷺ says, "I am concerned about my ummah for 6 things that will happen, that they will be doing in reality. Selling the governorship, that people buy positions in government, whether it's a low position or high position. Why is this scary? Because it's a sign of the closeness of the Day of Judgment. He's also saying the leadership of the fools, the leadership of the fools, the most stupid people are the ones leading big nations. We see this, and it's obvious. Why is this a sign of the Day of Judgment? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told His Prophet to tell us that when this happens, we should wait for the Day of Judgment, meaning the bigger signs should follow, and then the Day of Judgment will be very close. So the first is that governorship is for sale. He who has money, he can get the position. So if you want to run for office, in today's terms, you need millions of dollars. You may never make them back in salary, but they tell about the corruption behind the scene of the public. Because it's not wise. Anybody who has money, he should not spend $5-6 million to have a seat in a parliament or governing body, and then he will never make $5-6 million out of his salary. So how does he make up the profit? So it shows that governorship is not sought for public service, it is sought for what comes with it of under the table perks, or you could say illegal benefits. This is something very serious. But the Prophet ﷺ does not say in the hadith that buying the governorship is bad unless you have more money to squander. No, he says it leads definitely to corruption. It leads definitely to corruption, which means people are not seeking office to make money, but to make illegal money, because the office itself does not offer you as much as you put in it. The leadership of the fools, it is people who do not have the experience, do not have the knowledge, do not have the sense of good judgment, who are putting themselves for the others to elect them or to vote for them or to choose them or to appoint them. Why? Because a fool, by definition, in the Arabic language, they call it sufaha, unwise and fool people. People who do not know where to put their money. People who do not know how to manage their own money. People who do not know how to make good judgment. How could these people, be our own representatives? It doesn't make sense. We definitely have smart people in our ummah that could lead our ummah into better places. So this is the second in those sets of signs. Also, the increase in the number of police officers, kathratu shurat. We have so many police officers, and you see them in demonstrations. Sometimes they are bigger in size than the demonstration. Kathratu shurat, which means what? The ruler is abusing his power, using the arm of the soldiers on his behalf to suppress objections. When you suppress objections, do we expect you to be a righteous leader? When you ban people who are objected because they are objecting, is this going to be a sign of your righteous leadership? Of course not. So using a lot of police people, police force, and police brutality is a sign of the closeness of the Day of Judgment. Disconnecting the kin, disconnecting your relatives, is also a sign of the Day of Judgment. Of course, there are rules that govern when and when not to do it. The time is not going to allow me to go into details. But disconnecting your kin wantonly, or for fear that they will take some of your money, or they will ask you for something, this is a sign of the Day of Judgment. Also, one of the signs that we witness from time to time, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, people would push forward somebody to lead them, especially in prayer. The context here is in prayer. They do not put him in that position except to entertain them. They want to be their audio entertainment. This is also a sign of the Day of Judgment. The text of the hadith says, لا يقدمونه إلا ليغنيهم غناء ليس بأفقههم ولكن يقدمونه ليغنيهم غناء. He's not the most knowledgeable, Islamically speaking, or fiqh-wise, but he just has a good voice or a good recitation, so they push him forward. This is similar to somebody who has a status because of something, and we also push them into leadership position because of his status, not because he's going to lead well, not because he has experience. So those are some of the signs of the Day of Judgment that we can cover today. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us try to work around those signs and change the situations they create. Allahumma ameen. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحابته Among the signs of the Day of Judgment as well is another hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. Abu Huraira narrates that the Prophet ﷺ said that time will become closer and shorter. In another hadith, he himself explains, said that the day will count as a 1 hour, and the week will be counted, will be felt like 1 day, and the month is like 1 week, and the year is like 1 month. The shortness of time. There is no blessing in time anymore. We feel it. I hope everybody feels the same. You're always short on time, but we are always also squandering our times that we have. So the shortness of time is about our feeling and sense of time. On the other hand, there is also the fact that the trip that used to take a month or two in the desert is now taking half an hour by flight, or 1 hour by flight. So we have it on one hand, if you travel and move, but if you stay still, your time will always be shorter, especially if you squander your time. The second is the lack of knowledge or shortness of knowledge. There is a lot of knowledge available, but there is little knowledge that people have. So the internet and every other means and sources are running after us to learn something, right? They come into your own inbox, but you don't have the time to read it. And if you read it quickly, it's like a momentous effect, and then it fades away over time. So knowledge that people used to seek to practice, to learn and practice and teach others is not there anymore. وَيُلْقَ الشُّحْ. People will be as stingy as we see today. They have it, but they don't want to share it. They think it is theirs. That's also a sign of the Day of Judgment. Then, وَتَظْهَرُ الْفِتَنِ. Lots of chaos and trouble and confusion will start to come up. And we see it everywhere, especially in the Muslim world, but also in other places. So it is not limited to one community or the other. It's everywhere. And then the final one in this hadith is وَيَكْثُرُ الْهَرَجُ. So they asked him, what is al-haraj? He says, al-qatl. Al-haraj means killing. Killing will increase. I remember in the 80s, there used to be a crisis in Washington because of what they call drive-by shooting. People are running on a bike, a motorbike, and one of them is having a gun, and he shoots people walking in the streets. It was the capital of murder in America. So this is not only manifested in this way, but now when there is a war or a fight, the killing is much more. Every time there is a war, the casualties are many more than it used to be in previous wars. So this also is a sign of the Day of Judgment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from the horrors of the Day of Judgment. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt, wa qina wasrif anna sharra ma qadayt. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا، واجعله الوارث منا، واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا، ولا مبلغ علمنا، ولا إلى النار مصيرنا. اللهم لا تدع لنا في يومنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا دينا إلا قضيته، ولا مريضا إلا شفيته، ولا مبتلا إلا عافيته، ولا ضالا إلا هديته، ولا سائلا إلا أعطيته، ولا مجاهدا إلا نصرته، ولا ظالما إلا قصمته. اللهم عليك بالجبارين والطغاة والمعتدين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، فستذكرون ما أقول لكم، وأفوض أمري إلى الله، إن الله بصير بالعباد. وأقم الصلاة.